Today's devotion is taken from Genesis chapter 17 verses 15 to 19. It reads, God also said to Abraham, As for Sarai, your wife, you are no longer to call her Sarai. Her name will be Sarah. I will bless her and will surely give you a son by her. I will bless her so that she will be the mother of nations. King of peoples will come from her. Abraham fell face down. He laughed and said to himself, Will a son be born to a man 100 years old? Will Sarah bear a child at the age of 90? And Abraham said to God, If only Ishmael might live under your blessing. Then God said, Yes, but your wife Sarah will bear you a son, and you will call him Isaac. I will establish my covenant with him as an everlasting covenant for his descendants after him. This portion talks about Sarah, the mother who waited. Waiting is a miserable feeling. We all face it at different times in our life. In this passage, we see Sarah, the wife of Abraham. And when we go through her life, sometimes we wonder, what was the purpose of the wait? These times when we feel we are wasting away, that is when God works in us. There is a reason behind everything He does in our lives. It took 90 years to make Sarah the mother He wanted for Isaac. After all, it was through him that God was going to establish His covenant. Realize that God in His wisdom plans our lives. We have a God who prepares us for each challenge, each blessing He gives us, and through it He molds us and makes us more like Him. So what are we supposed to do? We can either trust Him or take matters into our hands. That's what happened in chapter 16 when Sarai sent Hagar to Abraham. She had given up and thought the only way to start a family was that. But all it resulted was in blaming and resentment. Even if we decide to trust and wait, there will be feelings of anger, doubt, confusion. But we must realize that we are not alone in it. We have a God who is alive and with us. We can talk to Him, we can write to Him, cry out to Him. Like the song goes, we have the privilege to carry everything to God in prayer, and we will find our solace there. He will take us to that place of peace where we can say, I will be still and know that You are God. Even Sarah doubted. We see in chapter 18 verse 12, she laughed to herself when the Godman said that she would bear a child. But their immediate response was, Is anything too hard for the Lord? It is a question we need to ask ourselves. He is the God who changed the childless Sarai to Sarah, the mother of nations. He loves us and has a greater purpose for us, greater than what we are willing to settle for. And remember that He is the sovereign God. Everything is under His control, and He makes all things beautiful in His time. Let's pray. Father, we thank You that You love us. Lord, we ask You to empty us of ourselves and fill us with Your Spirit. Help us, Lord, to wait in faith while You work on us and prepare us for the amazing things You have in store for us. All this we ask in Your mighty and precious name. Amen.